The best choice is E, PML. Let's look at some of the features that make PML the best answer here. You can see on flare there are multiple patchy T2 flare bright lesion that center within the white matter with involvement of subcortical U-fiber as well as some cortical involvement. And the lesion has very little mass effect, so that distinguishes it from other neoplasm. In addition, classically, you see there's very little enhancement or no enhancement associated with PML, so that can distinguish it from other lesions such as lymphoma. Typically, they are bilateral or at least multifocal, hence its name. When they are bilateral, they tend to be asymmetric in distribution. That is different from, say, PRESS. On the board exam, they can ask you the organism that's affecting PML, John Conahan virus. It's reactivation of the JC virus infecting oligodendrocyte causing demyelination. Classically, it affects immunosuppressive patients. The most classic example would be AIDS patient presented with multifocal patchy lesion like this. But any type of immunosuppressive state can potentially put the patient at risk with PML, including post-transplant patient, including patient like this case, undergoing MS treatment with immunosuppressive monoclonal antibody treatment. Rarely, but potentially can cause PML. In terms of trying to differentiate between progression MS versus PML, one of the helpful hints is that PML tend not to affect optic nerve or spinal cord, whereas MS, they do like to go to optic nerve or spinal cord. Let's look at some other answers that do not work as well in this case. For metastasis, it would be very strange to have a metastasis without enhancement. For choice B, ischemic infarction. There is no evidence to restrict diffusion. There's a bright signal in DWI, but no dark signal on ADC. But if you think about this being chronic infarction with T2 shine through with a bright ADC signal, for chronic infarction, I like to see more volume loss, which I don't see it here. So B is not the best answer. For tumor-effective MS, this is an example of a patient with MS. Notice the Dawson finger lesion as well as some of the lesion that's involved in the Y matter. You can have tumor-effective MS, which literally means mass-like. So you will have mass-like, tumor-like demyelinating disease, or sometimes you can have a standalone tumor-effective demyelinating lesion. At least classically, is that the enhancement tend to be incomplete rim enhancement or the horseshoe enhancement. So that's something unique to distinguish between a tumor-effective MS or tumor-effective demyelinating lesion versus PML. For hypertensive encephalopathy or posterior reversible encephalopathy syndrome, PRESS, the lesion tend to occur in a relatively symmetric fashion, and PML typically can be bilateral, but they tend to be asymmetric. And also the involvement of PRESS tend to occur, as you know, posteriorly and symmetrically involving the cortex as well as the subcortical white matter. And classically, they show no restricted diffusion. So vasogenic edema rather than cytotoxic edema. So the best choice here is choice E, PML in this case. That's all for this brain case number 9. Good luck on your board exam. Thank you.